Let us now look into examples of some functions or methods. Both are same. Whenever I call a function or method, both are same. So let us declare a function called addition and puts enter number 1 and a is equal to gets the value as an integer and puts enter number 2. B is equal to gets dot to I. After getting, add them plus B and puts the total of the total is get the value from the C end. Now let us declare one more function or method before going to test. Let us say subtraction SUB puts the same thing, I will be copying it, puts number 1. For copying, just press the arrow marks in the interactive Ruby. You will be getting all the lines according to the sequence. And now get the value of A and then ask for number 2. Get it inside the B. And now C is equal to A minus B. Now puts sub is equal to the pound symbol, two flower brackets inside that C. End. So both these functions or methods are standalone. So here C is different, here C is different. Now let us call addition. Enter number 1, 34. Enter number 2, 11. Let me bring it up little bit. And now press enter. The total is 45. Now if you want to call the subtraction method, just call it SUB. Now enter number 1, 48. Enter number 2, again let us give 48. See, subtraction is equal to 0. Like this we can write all the functions like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, everything, and we can create our own calculator. So this is different in writing in a file because we are using interactive Ruby. Here we are executing here itself, but in a file, how to write this, I will be showing in the next video. Until then, keep practicing. Define some other functions like for multiplications, divisions, and practice it more before going to the further session. Next session, I will be showing you how to write these functions in a file, and according to the user decision, we will be calling the function. Let us see that in the next video. Until then, keep practicing.